Hello everyone, this is Vivek here and I welcome you all to my prominent channel Education Unlimited. So I am again here with a new topic and our today's topic is algae and its general characteristics. So stay tuned, watch till end and don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. So let's start about knowing more about algae. So if we talk about algae, the first thing about algae is they are simple and chlorophyllous. It means they are simple in structure and contain the green pigment that is called chlorophylls. Students, you already know about chlorophyll. I am recalling, chlorophyll is a green pigment which is present in the plant, and by the help of that pigment, plants are able to make their own food. So algae are simple and chlorophyllous means they contain chlorophyll. Next thing about algae is algae do not having vascular bundle. It means algae are lacking vascular bundle. You know, vascular bundle is of two types, and that is xylem and phloem. Students, in algae the vascular bundle is absent. It means the transportation of water, mineral and food material is not done by the vascular bundle, means the xylem and phloem. Next thing about algae is they are autotrophic. So I have explained earlier that algae contain chlorophyll. So if they contain chlorophyll, it means they are able to make their own food, and that's why they are autotrophic in mode of nutrition. They make their own food and they are thallophytic. Here the thallophytic means, the term thallophytic means, if you break the term thallophytic, you get the two different terms, that is thallo and phytic. Phytic used for plants, and thallo means thallus like structure. Students, thallus like structures means the plant which is not differentiated into root, stem or leaf. You see, the whole plant is alike. It means there is no differentiation between root, there is no differentiation between stem, there is no differentiation between leaf. All the part of the plant is looking alike. And you know, one interesting thing about algae is, the scientists who are studying the algae, or you can say the branch of study dealing with the study of algae, is known as algology, or you can say phycology. Algology and phycology are used for the same meaning. Study of algae is called algology or phycology. Students, you are interesting to know about the term algae. So let me tell you, algae, the term algae is given by the scientist Linnaeus. And Linnaeus derived this term algae from a Latin word alga, that means seaweeds. Students, seaweeds means the plants, the parts of the plant which are present in the sea. So Linnaeus derived the term alga from the Latin word which means seaweeds. Okay, let me explain you some more salient features of algae, some more excellent features about algae, interesting features about algae. So here, if we talk about sex organs of algae, algae have both type of sex organs, like unicellular also and multicellular also. But when the algae having unicellular sex organ, the unicellular sex organ is non-jacketed. And when they are having multicellular sex organ, each cell is fertile. It means each cell is able to germinate and to grow into a new plant. The next thing about algae is there is no any formation of embryo after the fertilization in life cycle. It means that whenever the fertilization takes place, whenever the fusion of male and female gamete takes place, there is no any formation of embryo occurs in the algae. Most of the algae are aquatic. It means that most of the algae which you see on the earth, they are present in the aquatic nature or aquatic environment. They need humid, humid environment to survive, to grow. It means that most of the algae can be seen near aquatic regions or aquatic areas. Okay. Next thing about algae is, when there are two phases, students, as we are studying about the plant kingdom, so we have to know about that. In plants, there are two phases in life cycle. The one phase is called gametophyte, and the other one is called sporophyte. Gametophyte and sporophyte, these two phases are coming in the life cycle of plant kingdom, or the divisions of plant kingdom. Okay, so here when there are two phases are present in the algae, like gametophytic and sporophytic phase, they all are independent. It means gametophyte phase is not dependent upon sporophyte, and sporophyte phase is not dependent upon gametophyte. They both are independent. They are not depending upon each other. And one more important thing about the algae is, here gametophytic phase is prominent in life cycle. It means gametophytic phase is the main phase in the life cycle of algae. And you know, gametophytic phase is the phase of producing gametes in algae. And under favorable condition, you can say under suitable condition, the plant body reproduces asexually. It means here sexual and asexual both mode of reproduction is found in algae, but asexual mode of reproduction is found in most of the algae. So the plant body reproduces asexually by means of mitospores. So mitospores are the spores which are produced after mitosis. They are called mitospores. Students, here some more interesting facts about algae. You know, Dr. F. A. Frisch is known as father of algology. I repeat, Dr. F. A. Frisch is known as the father of algology. And M. O. P. Younger is known as the father of Indian algology. I repeat, M. O. P. Younger is known as the father of Indian algology.